Hi everybody, welcome back. I'm Disha and I'm here to help you transform your house into a home. And today, after a long time, I'm going to talk about traditional Indian painting. And today it's about Pichwai paintings of Nathdwara, Rajasthan. So first I have a request. If you are new here, then don't forget to subscribe this channel, because here I keep sharing about home decor and styling, gardening, DIY, art and craft and a lot of other stuff. So don't forget to subscribe when you are here. And now for today's video, first I'm gonna share why these paintings are called Pichwai paintings. So Pichwai is actually a combination of two Sanskrit words, pitch and vai. Pitch translates to back in English, which means piche in Hindi, and vai means hanging. So Pichwai paintings are actually hangings, wall hangings. Now, like always, I'll start with origin, then theme, style, and then the process of the painting. So first, origin. These paintings are said to have originated around 400 years ago. That's quite old. And still these paintings are practiced in Nathdwara, Rajasthan, and where the artists live, that particular place or that particular colony is called colony of artists, or better known as Chitrakaron ka Mohalla. And that particular street is called Street of Paintings, which is Chitron ki Gali. So yes, if you are in Rajasthan, then don't forget to visit Nathdwara, especially for these famous paintings, these famous traditional Indian paintings. Now for theme. These paintings mainly depict the life of Lord Krishna, 7-year-old Krishna. You might have heard about this story, this tale in your childhood too, that to safeguard people of Vrindavan, Bal Krishna picked up Govardhan Hill on his little finger. So this is very famous story that you would see in Pichwai paintings. And other than this, you will see seasons. So it's about Lord Krishna's life, his Ras Leelas and seasons. So if you see lot of lotuses around in a Pichwai painting, then it's about summer. And if you see lots of peacocks in a painting, then it's about rainy season. And if there are lots of jamwat pattern, then the painting is about winter season. Now for style, these paintings are known for intricate details and refined look. You will see Lord Krishna as a main figure or dominant figure placed in the center of the painting, and round face, large eyes, big nose, fat belly, and diamond studded on his chin. That's how Lord Krishna is depicted in Pichwai paintings. And other than Lord Krishna, you might see milkmaids or gopis, lotuses, lush green background, peacocks, and things like that. Now process. So the Pichwai paintings are done mainly on cotton cloth, huge cotton cloth. So cloth is first washed and then starched. Then first the sketch is made on the cloth, starched cloth, and then figures and patterns are filled with natural colors that are obtained from stones and gems, and sometimes pure gold is also used. And one more interesting fact that I would like to share here is that several artists work on the same painting simultaneously, because the painting's size is always huge. So several artists work on the same painting, and there is one master, or you can say master artist, pro artist, who's gonna supervise the entire process. And one painting can take from several weeks to months to complete. But these days artists are experimenting with their expressions, and they are making it on papers and on fabrics, on different kind of fabrics, trays, wall plates, and different surfaces. Pichwai paintings are really expensive because pure gold is used in them and natural colors are used in them, and there is a lot of hard work that goes into making one painting, so which makes it really expensive. To make it affordable for people like us, artists are experimenting with the art. They are making it very in a simple way. You will see just a cow and few lotuses, or maybe, and it can be without borders as well. So that's also Pichwai, but that is not in its purest form. That's all, that's about it. Now let's start making one.
Thank you.
So that's all for today. I really hope that this video was useful. Don't forget to check out my blog, because I'm gonna share the template of this painting on my blog. You can find the link in the description box below. And that's all for today. I'll see you soon in my next video. Till then, watch either this video or this. And if you try this art, then don't forget to share the recreation with me on my Instagram. This is my Instagram ID and this is my Facebook ID. Wish you all love, luck and sunshine. Bye-bye.